Hello, Shane here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. And if you're watching on Rumble, welcome there as well. Hope you're doing well. Beautiful day where I am, as you can see. Loving it. The world is as you think it is, right? I wanted to talk today about the call, the great calling that calls to us at a soul level. And how each of us come to this earth with a calling, and many are called, but few have the courage to step up and answer that call. So that's what we're going to be talking about. If you like the content, I would encourage you to subscribe to my channel, and a thumbs up always helps. So I appreciate that. I'm grateful for your support. I'm here to be of service, and that's what I'm attempting to do through these videos. So the call, what's calling to you? What's your purpose for being here on the earth? We can be very blasé about that. We can be very dismissive around what that is. And if you look at the masses, most people wouldn't have a clue about why they're here and what they're doing. Most people are caught up in their groundhog day, punching the clock, living somebody else's dream, or just simply oblivious on all fronts, a slave to the system. Certainly not living their best life. So the work I do, as you would know, if you watch my videos and see my social content, or if you've actually worked one-on-one with me, is I'm all about helping people firstly, recognize what's calling to them and then navigate the pathway to that calling. So it's important to know what's calling to you. And this is not about your vision, and this is not about what other people have placed on you. This is about the thing that calls to you from the divine and resonates here at a soul level. When you know what's calling to you and when you know what your destination is, it's so much easier to navigate and create the pathway to that outcome, because most people don't know what's calling to them. Most people don't know where they're going. And I can assure you that if you don't know what the destination is or where the destination is, it's almost impossible to arrive. So reaching out and being intentional around your calling and what is calling to you is where you will find your power, your freedom, and your release. So the big challenge here, of course, is that once you start to see what's calling to you, then you also begin to see what's preventing you from stepping into that calling, into the flow of all that is. This is the challenge, because when we understand and recognize that there are things that are holding us back, things, people, situations, we need to decide what we're going to do about those things, if we're going to let go of them, if we're going to try and incorporate those things into our journey. My experience tells me that if something is not working for you, it is working against you. And out of obligation and the programming that we all have when we come into this earth, into this experience, we feel a great deal of obligation around the very subtle manipulation that is thrust upon us. And that can be the barrier, the sense of letting people down because you're not doing what they told you that you would do while you were here. I mean, my grandmother, all her intentions were so good. She always put on me that I was going to be a minister of religion because I came to help people. And I went down that pathway, and it was not my calling, my pathway, but I did not want to let her down. I didn't want to let the other people down that had invested that into me and told me that that's what I was here for, when all along I had this pulling away from that and this conflict within me. And that was my lessening, my reckoning. Let me tell you that it was what some people would refer to as the dark night of the soul. because I was conflicted and confronted with everything that you could possibly imagine. Tearing away from that path that had been set before me, and finding the courage to do that. So there's a cost involved. Whenever you are presented with the opportunity to move forward, there's a cost involved. Whether you are prepared to pay that price or not will determine the effectiveness and the efficiency of you moving forward into your calling. Now, if you've been called to the shamanic path, this is not something you just decide to do when you wake up. This is a life path, a commitment, because to whom much is given, much is required of them. So very important to know how to navigate, very important to listen to what's calling to you. Now, there are a few things you can do. You can, and you should, you really should, have a mentor who guides you and directs you on your journey and on your path. I have three active mentors in my life that I am accountable to. I take their guidance and I seek their wisdom. And I will always have mentors in my life. The other thing you can do is when you're meditating, be very intentional around asking your creative source, the energetic field, your ancestors, asking for clarity, guidance, and direction around these things. If you don't know where you're going, how are you ever going to get there? You have to know what the destination looks like. And the tough thing, and this is why a lot of my messages are not popular with the masses, because you know what? This path asks for commitment, sacrifice, and it asks for nothing less than your all. So I want to encourage you that if you're feeling stuck, if you're feeling overwhelmed, if you're feeling inadequate, I want to tell you that everything you need is within you, because the sixth principle of shamanism reminds us that all power comes from within. And if you're feeling the impact of limitations and programming, I want to remind you that the second principle of shamanism reminds us that there are no limits. Learn the nine principles. Incorporate them into your vocabulary. Incorporate them into your speech, into your conversations, into your thought life. Learn to challenge your program and make sure they're in alignment with the nine principles. Do this and you'll have a far greater chance and advantage of arriving than those who don't. So the world is as we think it is. So we need to be intentional and very focused around what we're projecting, how we're seeing our reality, and what that looks like in this physical realm. You didn't come to live Groundhog Day every day. You didn't come to live somebody else's dream. You came here for an immaculately designed and divine purpose that is critical to the evolution, for the elevation of humanity. So I just want to encourage you in this. I want to encourage you to go deeper within you. I want to encourage you to learn to dream deeper, to learn to journey into the energetic realms, and to reach out if you are feeling stuck and need some guidance. You can book a discovery session with me through my website. There is a little bit of a waiting list, but shamanmcleay.com. I just encourage you to go there, have a look. There's some resources there that might help you. They're absolutely free. And, you know, take responsibility for where you are and where you're going. You know, you are completely worthy of good things and you are completely worthy of good outcomes. Silence the programming that is working against you, because if it's not working for you, it is working against you. And the fears around you, the fears that you're potentially embracing, that are causing limitations, I want to make this very clear that what you fear will own you. So I hope this has helped. I appreciate you being here. Like I say, if you find this valuable or helpful, I would really appreciate you subscribing, and that way you can continue to get notifications when I upload a new video, and you can share this with your friends as well if you feel this would help them. So thank you, and remember, there is a very powerful divine calling that has your name on it, and it is you, as unique as your fingerprint, because you are unique, you are divinely created, you are one of a kind, and I believe in you because I know that this is the order and the divine flow of the universe and the creative source. Have a great day.